Hello everyone. In this video, I'll be talking about Apache Kafka. So what is Apache Kafka? Apache Kafka is basically an open source distributed stream processing platform, and how it can be used, let us try to understand. So Apache Kafka basically processes streams of data. Using this, you can actually publish records, subscribe to records, store real-time data, process and extract real-time incoming or outgoing data, and take decisions based on how the real-time data is shaping up. Let us try to understand more in detail. So Apache Kafka is basically set up on a cluster. It runs on multiple servers. It's a distributed system. It works on TCP. The communication is done on TCP, so it is reliable. Kafka provides us multiple APIs using which we can configure it. It provides producers, there are producers, consumers, stream APIs, connector APIs, admin APIs. So admin APIs are basically used to configure various parameters on the configuration part, whereas you can actually use the producer API to produce content. Similarly for consumer API to consume the records. Stream API, connector API is to basically connect multiple data sources and either pull in data or stream data out of Kafka. Let us try to understand basics of Kafka. So in Kafka, when you deploy Kafka on a server, it's called a broker. A broker can have multiple topics, and topics can have multiple records. A record is nothing but key, value, and timestamp. A record can be considered, can be thought of something of this key value pair, where it has three keys. Like it has timestamp and key and value. So let us try to understand what are the basic features of Kafka and why is it so popular. So Kafka has high throughput. It is highly durable. You write the real-time data into you persist that data and you can retrieve it at a later point of time as well. So that makes it highly durable. It supports data replication. So a data record, multiple replicas of the data are maintained across clusters, spread across different regions. And that makes it data replicate. Okay. That makes the Kafka support data replication and makes it work in various use cases. It takes care of stream processing. So real-time data, incoming data, we can actually process the real-time data stream. So that makes it highly useful. It is a distributed system and hence it is highly scalable. Let us try to understand what are the key components of a Kafka platform. So as I mentioned earlier, the basic entity is a message record. It's basically a schema of key value pairs. Then comes topic. Now, topic can be thought of as queues, but here it is different. A topic can be distributed in multiple partitions, and these partitions can be put on different clusters. So, you can actually write records in multiple partitions, and these partitions can be spread out on different machines. So that is what a topic is. And like these all partitions are under one topic. So what happens is you can actually have multiple producers. Like a producer can keep writing to a partition of a topic, and there could be multiple consumers reading the previously written records. Then comes the concept of brokers and distribution. So as I told you earlier, brokers are nothing but Kafka servers. A broker is the Kafka cluster is acting as a broker, and from that you can have multiple producers writing to that broker for a particular topic, writing records on a particular topic on a cluster, and there could be multiple consumers reading records of that particular topic or any other topic which is available on this cluster. So that's how this diagram shows brokers, producers and consumers. Producers are just writers or publishers. Consumers are subscribers or readers. Here is a concept of stream. What is stream? So a stream is a bi-directional data. Like you can have a Kafka cluster which writes data to application. You can have an application writing data back to Kafka. So a Kafka cluster supports read and write on the same I/O stream, and that's basically what a stream is defined as part of Kafka. Then there comes the connector. As I told you earlier, in the connector API, you can have multiple data sources, all of them reading and writing to the same Kafka clusters at the same time. So that makes it interoperable and allows you to ingest, process data from multiple data sources. And that's what makes Kafka highly used in various use cases. Let us try to understand a few use cases of Kafka. You can use Kafka to build real-time data processing services. You can use it for ETL, extract, transform, and load data frameworks. You can have storage systems, real-time storage systems. You can have messaging notification services built on top of Kafka. You can have activity tracker on websites, which is tracking data in real-time. So anything that is to do with real-time data processing, you should think of applying the concept of Kafka there. I know it is very compressed version of what actually Kafka can be explained about, but this would definitely help you get a basic understanding of Apache Kafka and will help you in your system design interviews. I hope this is useful, and if you find this video useful, please like, comment and subscribe this channel, and do share in your comments how or what topics you would like me to explain further. I hope this helps you in some way. Thank you very much for watching.